MATSIDE TV. I'm at Hilliard Darby High School with the athletic director, Chris Ludman. Chris, first thing I'm going to ask is about the new mat in the middle. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Well, the mat is actually the Central District mat, and we just borrowed it. Anybody out there that wants to borrow the mat, they're more than welcome. But it is a new mat. It's a little sticky. The kids love it. It's something a little bit different. It looks like a little rock, and they love it.
And I know you host the, I believe, the districts here.
We do, yes.
Correct?
Mm-hmm.
Will that be here for the district meet?
It will be here for the district meet. I'm just not sure if it fits or not. So that's what we're kind of looking for, because we put four mats out, these three and then the one over there. So we just have to make sure that it fits. But it will probably be here for district.
We talked a little bit early on in the season. I think it was the first duel that you had with Dublin
Jerome.
Yep. So from that point, how are things going for you?
Things have been great. We have a young team. We've known that, and they've been coming around sooner than we thought. We knew that they were tough. We knew that they would, they were hard workers, but we thought that our success would come a little later in the season. But with a lot of duels, they've been really coming together and fighting for those bonus points, saving bonus points, and we're sitting at 9-2 right now.
So. That's fantastic. I know I kind of looked at your webpage, and I think it's a great thing that you've done.
Thank you.
You've got, I think, just two seniors, as far as those that are in the lineup?
Two, maybe three.
Okay, two or three. Definitely.
We've got four seniors on the team. Zane Hypes, Jake Henley, D'Amico Barnes, and Sean Hazelton. And all of them bounce into the varsity lineup here and there.
Okay. Good. How about this mat that we're standing on? What do you think?
I like it. It looks really good. We've had it at our home tournament for some, our home gym for some tournaments before. It's a little sticky. It's tacky. It's got a little bit of a different feel. But it's a wrestling mat. You know, you play on different baseball fields when you're in that sport, different football fields.
Right.
It has the same dimensions, so we're okay with it.
You know, last time I talked to you, I didn't ask you what you did at Delaware, what you taught and so forth. Maybe you can talk a little bit about that real quick.
Sure. I am an English teacher.
Okay.
I teach mostly sophomores and American literature, juniors.
Very challenging, I'm sure.
It's fun.
It's fun?
It's
okay.
Fun.
Okay.
Good kids.
Well, you know, this is going to be a good duel tonight.
Yep.
I think we're looking at an OCC Cardinal.
That's right.
Cardinal division.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, they seem to change things a lot on me, and I got to keep up to date.
Yeah.
Both the teams are, you know, it's early, but both undefeated.
Sure.
Hopefully it'll be a good thing for both squads, and I know you guys will be prepared.
So will they. They always are. We put Darby, Coach Moody and I, we got our programs together back before they made the configuration, and we have similar programs, I think. A bunch of tough kids. We've learned over the years you never underestimate any Darby wrestler. They always come ready to go for this one, and we expect it to be a brawl.
Okay. Well, I appreciate you talking to me. Good luck today. Okay, I'm with Mark Reap, a veteran official in the Central District. Mark and I go back quite a ways. We've worked together, but this should be an interesting duel.
Yeah, I think so. I've had Darby earlier this year against Worthington Kilbourne. I have not seen Delaware, but they always are pretty good. I mean, their coaches get their kids ready, and I think it's going to be a good duel tonight.
We have a full lineup, so we've got all 14 weight classes. Some pretty good matches. I know that Darby's got a couple state qualifiers.
Yep.
But like you just said, Delaware is always well prepared. Now I want to ask you a real tricky question here.
All right.
How about this mat?
Well, it's interesting, isn't it? It's the first time. I've never officiated on stone before, so it's going to be interesting tonight to see. Hopefully we don't get confused with the out-of-bounds and the various lines. I think we'll get that figured out, but it'll be a new experience.
Okay.
I've never been on a mat like this.
You know, I didn't ask last night at our meeting, but I did want to talk a little bit about it. Postseason, I know you'll be involved in sectionals.
Mm-hmm.
I'm assuming districts.
We haven't been told. I'm hopefully.
Oh, yeah. And so they don't. Have we been told about who the state qualifiers are?
Yes, we have. Doing the individual is going to be Tim and Troy Cameron,
okay.
Tom Martin, and I can't think of who the other one is off the top of my head. And then I know for the team duels, myself, Freddie Fox, AJ Sinteri, and I think there's one other gentleman, but I can't think of.
So fantastic. You're doing the team duels.
Yes, sir.
I will be down there on the scoreboard, the clock and so forth. So hopefully that's going to work out. That's fantastic. So congratulations.
Yeah, you and I have done that a few times together.
Good luck tonight. Have fun and do what you need to do.
Yeah.
All righty.
We will. Thanks, Rick.
Okay. I'm with Coach Bob Stoll. I'm going to call you Coach.
Okay.
Bob and I go back quite a ways. I know you.
The
1970s. Tell me where you've been during that time.
I started out at Bishop Reedy as head coach. Then I went to Lakota in 1988 for 7 years. Then I came back to Dublin Kaufman.
Okay. I know where we met probably was at Reedy when I was coaching.
Oh, yeah.
And then you were kind enough to hire me as an official. I'm not sure why, but you did that. It was a great tournament. I don't know. I don't think they're doing it anymore. But let's talk about this mat since I'm standing on it.
Well, this is a mat that we had some donations, and we kind of put the donations with a little effort forward. And we got some guys to donate some money, and we got the mat. And the Officials Association donated part of this, too. So that's good. But the mat is Resolite's first mat they used for the College All-Star Meet last year up in Cleveland. It's a Resi-Lock mat. It's a top-of-the-line mat that they have. And Hilliard Darby has the mat, and if anybody ever wants to borrow it for a tournament, they just contact, Hilliard Darby, Moody, Coach Moody, and, Brendan will set it up for you, and, you just use it.
I think it's fantastic. I know that I was talking to Josh a little bit ago. He said they've used it for their tournament.
Yeah.
I'm sure other schools will do that, and what a great thing that you did for this. And I'm sure that hopefully business is good.
Oh, yeah. Resolite, since they came out with lightweight mats, it's incredible. It's just, everybody's buying them up, and they're going to, everything's great.
I remember some of the mats we used to have to roll around on, and I'm sure you do too.
We started with horsehair mats and went to rubberized mats, and I've been through all kind of things. I remember Bob Dealey, when he was doing a program here, he'd have us in the sunshine. He had old horsehair mats, and he'd pull them off the walls for us to wrestle around them. It's crazy. So
Well, listen, it was great to see you, and I'm sure I'm going to catch you down the road a little bit somewhere. So good talking to you, Bob.
Okay,
thank you. Welcome to MATSIDE TV. I'm Rick Baker, and I will be your announcer tonight for this OCC Cardinal Division duel. We have two fantastic programs, Hilliard Darby, and I believe last year they had five or six that qualified to the state tournament, and of course Delaware Hayes, who we saw earlier, very solid program. I'm looking for some very fantastic matches. A couple things that I noticed on the lineups, both schools are very young. In fact, there's only two seniors that are participating tonight for both squads. A lot of 10th and 11th graders. So we're going to have some exciting matches. We've got a couple state-ranked wrestlers that you should be looking at. I know at 195 for Hilliard Darby, Jared Ball. Jared is a senior. He is a two-time state qualifier, finishing third both times. The heavyweight, Jacob Cover, also a senior. He was a state qualifier last year. On the other side for Delaware Hayes, we have Zach Williams. Zach is going to be wrestling at 132 tonight, which is the weight we start with. He is a two-time state qualifier also. So a lot of good guys sprinkled in the lineup. I think it's going to be a great match. So sit back, grab yourself a beverage, and let's enjoy wrestling. Have fun. All right.
And now introducing the starting lineups for your varsity teams. At 106 pounds, from Delaware, Tomas Eder. And from the Panthers, Alex Ventura. At 113 pounds for Delaware, Josh Bell. And for Hooter Derby, Zach Lithaluxa.
Lithaluxa.
At 120 pounds for Delaware, Briston Cold Iron. And for the Panthers, Austin Craycraft. At 126 pounds for Delaware, Zach Rackapaw. And for the Panthers, Isaac Richards. At 132 pounds for the Pacers, Zach Williams. And for your Panthers, Cade Ryan. For Delaware, at 138 pounds, Tristan Burton. And for the Hilliard Derby Panthers, Ben Brown. At 145 for Delaware, Jacob Henley. And for Darby, Carter Holt. 152 pounds from Delaware, Clay Ars. And for the Panthers, Caden Rayburn. At 160 pounds for Delaware, Corbin May. And for Darby, Isaiah Benneker. At 170 pounds, Delaware, Mason Sutander. And for Darby, Justin Shaw. At 182 pounds for Delaware, Jacob McCloskey. And for the Panthers, Rodney Benneker. At 195 pounds for Delaware, Zane Hypes. And for the Panthers, Blaine Barnes. At 220 pounds from Delaware, Nathan Robinson. And for the Panthers, Sam Donnelly. And at 285 pounds for Delaware, Javon Kane. And for your Panthers, senior Jacob Cover. Tonight's match will begin at 138 pounds.
Darby High School. We started at 132 pounds. For Darby, Cade Ryan. Cade is an 11th grader. And for Delaware, we have Zach Williams, and Zach is a 10th grader. State qualifier last year for Zach.
Zach Williams for Delaware. Change in lineup at 132 pounds for the Panthers, Ryan Blackerby.
Okay, we already have a change. So this may happen a little bit throughout the night. Ryan, let me see if I got him on my list here. Ryan Blackerby, and he is a 10th grader. So, first match, and we've got a change. Okay. Mark Freep is our official tonight. Mark is a veteran official. Got a takedown for Williams. As I was mentioning real quick here, Mark is a actually a state official this year. He's going to be doing the team duels. Very deserving of that. So, okay, he's got a leg in, working for hand control here. Nice return to the mat. Interesting rule changes here with the uniform, and I think you can see it right away with Mr. Williams, Mr. Zach. He is has the school-issued shorts and shorts. He's going to kick him.
Escape one.
We're at 2-1. 2-1.
Hey, 45. Your shot.
Kind of looking for a shrug or a throw by there. Didn't get it. Once he works in a little bit close. Nice shot on the leg. Countered well. Goes back in on a single. See if he can score from here. Got a nice little fight here. We're looking for the clock here. Oh, there we go. We're at 5 seconds. And we should have a 2-1 score, I believe. Scoreboard shows 2-0, but I know it's 2-1. Okay, we are 2-1.
Okay. Delaware choice on even matches.
Okay. Okay, we're starting the second period. Red will choose down. Red typically is a visitor's color as we go through these dual meets. So okay. Ryan Blakerby, and I was just informed the scoreboard is off to my right, so it is right. It's 2-1. Working a nice deep path. He's got legs in. Okay, let's see if he can score here. Ryan is a 10th grader. He's close to backs. Got to be 45 degrees or less.
You got a minute. Keep working.
Very, very nice leg ride. Just warm the bottom man. He hasn't really done too much to improve his position here. But we'll see what happens here. He is working real well in that half with the leg in. A lot of pressure on the shoulder. Yeah. We are down to about 10 seconds in the second period. We have a 2-1 score. Ryan did a nice job of riding him there.
The varsity scoreboard is located at your left near the Panther Nation. The middle score is
on,
team Mike. Eight.
Pick it up, bro. Pick it up. Come on, buddy. Rush now, let's go. Get tired. Come on, get it. You got it.
Okay, third period. Ryan shoots down. Got to his feet real well. Got a hand fight. Let's see if it works here. We got legs in on the other side now. Not quite in. Okay, not much there holding him down. Let's see if he can come out of this. Got a tight.
Keep going.
Coach thought that was a full Nelson there. Okay, we have a nice tight half here. He's got his three. So we are third period.
Come on, back to me.
There's a fall. So 4 minutes. Okay.
Way to finish.
Good match. We will go to 138. At 138, we have Ben Brown from Hilliard Darby. and it looks like Tristan Burton. Okay. Tristan is a 10th grader. Ben Brown is an 11th grader and a district qualifier from last year. So, trying to slide by, nothing yet. Got a nice crowd here tonight for this Cardinal Division OCC dual meet. Both teams are undefeated in the league. There's a nice slide by takedown. He's got the he's got a bar. He can grab that, go an opposite side half, or he can get the wrist, either way. Okay, look for the cradle. Done a nice job of coming out. We're 2-1, minute gone into the first period here. Okay, we're going to go to the boundary.
1 minute left in the first period, 1 minute.
Okay, that came right at us, but everything's fine. Okay. We're a little under a minute here. Tristan, as I mentioned, is a 10th grader. Nice shot on the leg, the single there, countered pretty well. Let's see if he cuts across. If he cuts across on a double, he can score. Ran out of bounds. Okay.
Hey, we got a minute. Don't fire me, Burton.
Yeah. Did a little adjustment on our table, and we're back at it here. Nope, they're out of bounds. I'm amazed at this, Matt, but my understanding is that it can be used throughout the district. I was talking to Bob Stoll, who was instrumental in bringing this Resolite mat here. So we're at a little under 10 seconds to go in the first period, and we're looking at a 2-1 score. In favor of Delaware, which will be Tristan Burton. Start the second period. Ben chose down. I don't know if I've mentioned this or not. He is an 11th grader and also was a district qualifier last year. Okay, we stopped that as potentially dangerous. Back second period here, and Deller's working on top there. See what? Okay, we got called red for stalling. He's got to come off the hips. I would agree with that call. He's got to show a little bit more action there. He was on the hips. Mark felt that he needed to work a little bit, so we had a stalling call. Ben worked to his feet the first period. There he goes. He's back on his feet. Arm cut off. And they're out of bounds. Okay.
Focus on the breakdown. Good breakdown. You're fine.
That was close to an escape, but he didn't feel that. I'll get with you in just a sec, okay? I was asked where you can see this. A couple different places. You can see it on Spectrum Channel 25. Wow, Channel 20. Okay, we just had a quick change of events there. Getting back points. He's got his two. Now he's got a bar. Let's see if he takes the opposite side wrist or half. Holding two, he's got two.
We're at
4-1. A little over 30 seconds left in the first period. Okay, now we've worn the bottom man for stalling.
Hey, let's go.
So both been worn. Looking for a Peterson. Let's see if he gets it. Okay. Okay, we had a reversal two and then came back with a reversal. So by my account, okay, there's going to be a question here. So that could have been no points either way. We had a Peterson by Hilliard Darby.
Darby, two near fall, and then two reversal back to Delaware.
Okay. So what just happened there? We had a reversal by way of a Peterson. He scored his two reversal. He scored, this would be Darby, got his two back points. Then Delaware, Tristan, came out up on top. So when it's all said and done, we had 4-2. Now the score is 6-5. Tristan Burton still ahead by one. We still have a discussion with Josh. He's fine with the outcome, maybe not fine, but he accepted it, and we're ready to go.
Delaware chooses down to the third period.
Okay, we are starting the third period. He game one, so we're at 7-5.
Game one, Delaware, we're in a neutral start the third period.
Okay, so we are in a neutral position. Got a nice match going here. Let me go back to the where this can be seen. Probably the best thing is if you go to YouTube and MATSIDE TV. Okay, we are out of bounds. Okay, we're a takedown away from a tie. He's pushing him a little bit here. Nice firemen. He scored on that. And he's got backs. He could tie this match up here. They're out of bounds. So on that lateral drop, he got two, and he got two on the near fall.
1 minute, 9 seconds.
We are 9-7 in favor of Hilliard Darby. Which is Ben Brown. Okay, now we're ready to go. Now we're at 9-8. Pretty gutsy call, but yet he feels that he can take him down. So one's been called. They've both been warned for stalling. That may come up here. They're out of bounds.
Come on, Ben.
45.
Ben is up by one. If he can score from here. Nope. Back in on that lateral drop. Very nice. He's got the two.
No backs, though. So. No, you got to have both supporting parts in. We got 11-8. Okay, we're at 11-8 with 23 seconds left. Okay, we are at a little under 5 seconds. It's like Tristan Burton from Delaware. So Ben Brown was the winner, and we had 11-8. Okay, we are at 145 pounds. Let me see who we have here. We're changing the lineup a little bit. I know we have, I believe it's Carter Holt, who's an 11th grader for Darby, and Jacob Henley, he's a senior from Delaware Hayes. So. Carter came in on a single. See if he can finish here. There he goes. If he can drive across, he can score here. Jacob's doing a nice job, and they're out of bounds. So, no score. We have a 6-3 score, team score, after just a couple matches. Little over 40 seconds left, no score. Carter's an 11th grader, and Jake, as I mentioned, is a senior. I believe he had a 7-7 record coming in, so he was 500 so far for the season. Okay, we have 20 seconds left. Still no score. Got his underhook on the, he had it on the left side. Let it go here. And we're, okay. Green will defer. Green in this case was Darby.
Henley chooses down to start the second period.
Which is Carter. Jake chose down, and he was given the given an uncontested escape. Tried to slide by, didn't get it. Okay, nice attempt there. Mark's talking to him a little bit, make sure that everything stays under control. I like that. That's a very good thing to do at this point. He's got that kind of underhook, and he's snapping the head. He underhooks on the right side, and then he snaps the head down as a setup. See if he goes back to it. So he's got the underhook, and a little throw by. Didn't score. Now he scored. He's got a takedown. Now we're at 3-0.
Work that head up. All right, guys, work up. Up inside. Work up. Work up.
Okay. He's got to keep that legal. He's got the arm. I went to a cradle. Nice cradle. He should be able to score here. There it is. Nope. Not quite. He still has the cradle. Still has the cradle. Got the call. Nice sequence. Jake had the cradle. He kept it. Carter came back, almost re-cradled on that last match. And then Jake came back up on top and got the fall. Okay, so now at 152, we have Caden Rayburn. He is a 10th grader and was a district qualifier for Delaware Hayes. We have Clay, I'm going to say ours, only a 9th grader. So there's a nice takedown, went right to a half. We could get a quick fall in here. He's got one leg in. Scored the three on the near fall. So we're at 5-0. And got a nice crowd. They're going to be on my table here real soon. But that's all right. I can get some names. He's got a leg in. A Turk. He's scoring off that Turk. Can they get the fall here? He does.
Win by four at 116 for Caden Rayburn.
So we are now 12-9 in favor of Delaware Hayes. We're at 160 pounds. Okay, for Delaware Hayes, Corbin May. Corbin is a district qualifier, 10th grader. He was 14-4 last year for Hilliard Darby. We have Isaiah Benneker. Looks like the first of the Benekers that comes up on the match. Isaiah is a 9th grader. So. So we're moving right along in the match here. We've got a 12-9 score. We're into the fifth match. Nice takedown on the... Okay, he's out of bounds. Corbin scored on a double leg there. Takes the top position. Went to a far ankle pick. Did a nice job. Broke him down. They're on the edge. A nice tight cradle, but out of bounds. Okay, we'll go back to it and see. Last time he went to that far ankle and a chop and didn't get it this time. Isaiah Isaiah got to his feet real quick that time. He got his escape. We got a double leg across. He scores. And looking for back points. Got a half and an arm. That's tight. Got 45 seconds. Got the fall. Okay, we're at 119 on the fall. So that's six more points for Delaware Hayes. Okay, we're going to 170. And at this point, for Darby, we have Mason Sutander from Delaware.
Justin Shaw.
Mason is a 10th grader. He is 10-5. He's got seven pins early part of this year. Justin Shaw from Hilliard Darby. Justin is an 11th grader. We had a quick takedown. He got the legs in. Nope, they're out. So, through five matches, we've had four falls and an 11-8 decision. That takes us to 18-9 in favor of Delaware. He's got an arm bar, opposite side wrist. Now he goes to the half. And he's going to stack him and score in here. Nice fall. Okay, another six for the Delaware. We are now at 24-9.
182 pounds for Delaware, Jacob McCloskey. And for the Panthers, Rodney Benneker.
Okay, at 182 pounds, we have Rocky Benneker. Rodney is a 11th grader. He is currently 14-4. Ranked eighth in the Central District poll. His opponent is Jacob McCloskey. He's a junior and he's 10-5. So I'd say we have a pretty good matchup here at 182 pounds. Okay. Darby's going to need a couple falls or some scoring here to get back in the match, but we still have a ways to go. Actually, we have three mats going tonight. We got a freshman mat to my left, and on the far mat to my right, we have a JV match, which is fantastic. Okay, I like to see the numbers for both these schools. That's great. Actually, maybe to my left is more of a middle school match. I look down there. Yeah, looks like the match on the left is a middle school match. Okay, we have no score. We have 20 seconds left.
Keep it up, Jacob. 20 seconds.
Mark reminded them to keep everything clean, wrestle, watch the hands and the face. And we have no score. Okay, we start the second period. Rodney will choose down. Okay. Okay, he got the escape. Real quick, he got to his feet. We got a 1-0 score. Had a question on the starting position there, but I didn't think anything was illegal on it. But coaches are always asking for, you know, a point here or there. Okay, we're ready to go. Both on their feet. And Rodney is up one. Yep. Tell him to stay out of the face. Delaware on the stall here. Now he's got a front headlock. Let's see if he scores off this. Goes to a single. Nope. Now we're going the other way. A little under, about 35 seconds left in the second period here. Still 1-0 match in favor of Hilliard Darby's Rodney Beneker. Time. Okay. All right. We're into the third period. Jacob will go down, which makes sense. He gave him one. So we are tied up, 1-1. Nice double leg attack. Jacob fought it off with a whizzer, so we're back at it. We are 1-1. We do have a stalling call on Delaware on Jacob. Looking at Ronnie kind of initiating more of the action here, but not able to score. So there's a shot on the double. Fought off by a wizard. See if he takes him across. Drive across. No. Out of bounds. He may, we're on blood time. Okay, we're blood time here, so. What I just saw there? Okay. While we're on blood time, you know, it's been an interesting match so far. We've had 5 falls, which you can score some points there, obviously 6. We had an 11-8 match, and currently we are tied up 1-1, so blood time is still going. I thought it would go this way. Delaware has a little bit more strength in the middle, I think, but we're a long ways away from them. So we're back at it. Okay, a little less than a minute to go. Jacob has been warned for stalling. Let's see if he hits him here. Okay, one after a single. Let's see if he gets it. They're out of bounds.
Okay. 37 seconds.
Okay, on the edge there. Pretty soon we're going to have 20 on the mat here instead of the two. Okay, we're at 15 seconds. Nice shot there. Okay, went after him there. We're at 5 seconds. We're going to go to overtime. Okay, we're back to a little bit of blood time, but I think we're going to get it taken care of. As I mentioned, we've got a middle school match, I believe, going on the far mat. And down at my far end, we have the JV teams wrestling. So great participation. Okay, we're back. 1 minute on the clock. First scores. Four score wins. Little attempt there. Rodney has been pushing the action, but not scoring here.
30 seconds left in overtime.
Okay, we are at 20, about 25 seconds. There's a shot. Okay, is he going to score here? Nope. Wizards in. Got nothing there. And they're out of bounds. Nice scramble. We're at 14 seconds. Out of bounds. Okay, we are in this 30 second. Okay, 30 seconds, they'll keep wrestling here. Jake goes down. And Rodney will take the top position. Again, they're going to go 30 seconds. And we're going. Okay, he's got it. Got his one. Escape. So we are at about 15 seconds. Jacob is up by one on that escape. If he finishes his double leg here. Drive it across. Got a takedown. Darby, and they're out of bounds. All right. So we are 3-2.
Come on, Jacob. There you go.
This is the second of the 30 seconds. Got an arm bar in. Opposite side half. Rodney Binneker is the winner, and 3-2 and OT and overtime. Okay, we're going to 195. I thought we would see Jared Ball, but I believe he is out of action right now. So we have okay, we're all right, let me see what we have on the line up here. We've got at 195. I'm not sure I have the names for these guys here. We'll have to get the... Who's this for Delaware?
Zane Hyde.
Oh, is it Zane?
Yep.
Okay, I got him.
Yep.
Thank you.
Yep.
All right. Yeah, Darby is Blaine Barnes. Blaine is a ninth grader. And for Delaware, we have Zane Hypes, who is a senior district alternate last year. He is currently 12-3. So we had a substitution. Okay, we are at 195, and the mat score, team score, I should say, is 24-12 in favor of Hilliard, or in favor of Delaware Hayes. Nice attack on the leg, comes out through the middle, and he scores his two, and he's looking for a cradle here, which he will get. Which is tight. He got three near fall. Looking at 5-0, a little under 10 seconds here. Walt, make sure I get that right. Charlie is an 11th grader. Zane is a senior, so. Got three on the near fall. We're at 10-0. So he's got a major decision. He's going back for a few more here. Okay. Got to settle back on that reverse half. And then he comes across. Very nice. Gonna lift ahead. He'll score. Boom. He's got it. It's over there. It's over there. Okay. That makes the score 30-12. Okay, we have Sam Donnelly for Hilliard Darby. I have Sam as a ninth grader, so another young man from Hilliard Darby. Nate Robinson is a 10th grader. He's a 10th the 10th grader. He's got the two, and looks like he's going to get a fall. He does. That was at 24 seconds. All right.
At 285 pounds for Delaware, Javon King.
Okay, so we are at the heavyweight match. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Our 10th match. Okay, we have Jacob Cover. Jacob is a senior. I have a record of 22-4. He was a state qualifier last year. Nice takedown. And he was second at the Medina tournament. Javon Kane is a 10th grader. I guess it's Javon. There's a nice strong bar. I think we're going to get a fall here. That's nice and tight. They just put the weight on him. There's the fall at 40 seconds.
That's a one-minute fall for Jacob Cover.
All right. The object of wrestling is to get the fall, and we have had a number of them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 of the 10 matches have come by way of pins. Now we're back around to the lightweights. At 106, we have Axel Ventura. He's a 10th grader from Darby. He is 6-4. And for Delaware Hayes, we have Tomas Etter. He's a 9th grader, 6th grade, 6-8 on the season. Okay, he's got the arm back. See if he comes across on this hammerlock.
Hey, grab the head, there you go.
Okay, nice setup there. This one may be, this one might be quick. Okay, he's got the three, we're at 5-0. We're at 36-18, and Darby definitely needs some falls here. They're on their way on this one. Let's see if he can score off this cradle. Got to settle his hips a little bit. Nope, got the three.
Three, near fall.
Threw the leg in. We're at 8-0. About 25 seconds left in the first period. Axel's been pretty dominant this period. With an 8-0 score, we're down to about 5 seconds here. And we're time after the first period. Green will go neutral, start the second period.
He's chosen neutral to begin the second period.
Axel's got a front headlock. Let's see if how he scores on this. Came back, went off the headlock to the single. He's going to, if he keeps walking around, he can score here. There he goes. Limp arm out. And there's limp arm. Very nice.
Takedown two for Ventura.
So we are at 10-0.
He's got a crossface. Maybe look for a crossface cradle here.
Let's go, Axel!
He's working it. There it is. He's got it locked. Now he's gonna. He's got to take it back slow. Didn't hold him there for the two count. Okay, we're at 10-0, 40 seconds left, second period. Let's see what he does. He got the arm back. He scored off this in the first period. Let's see if he can score again. Keeps the arm in the back, got to keep it legal. Come around, get the wrist. There's a hammerlock coming here. And he set that up well, but he just didn't score. Had to get his hips down a little bit. So we are into the third period with a 10-0 score. Okay. Axel will choose. He will choose down. Start the third period.
Let's go, Axel! Let's go, Axel! Come on, Axel!
Okay, he's working on getting the hand control, bringing himself up. There he comes up, spins through. He's gonna. Delaware still in control, but soon to lose it. There's a reversal. Okay, we got two reversal. Okay, we're going back to that hammerlock that I call step on the head, keep the head down, get the wrist. And that's tight. Okay. Going to use that as potentially dangerous. Oh, we're getting jumpy a little bit. We're going to caution. Okay, caution green there. Just got to settle in. There we go. So we got about a minute left. Let's see if he goes back to that. I call it a hammerlock. I don't know if that's what everybody else would use. Yep.
So he's 1 minute left in the match.
Pulling it out. Nope. And changing off to a possible cradle. Yep. There it is. We got about 35 seconds left. We have a major decision right now. Eight to 14 points spread is a major decision. Score three more. Now we're warned for stalling on the bottom. We got about 10 seconds left. Axel's going to be the winner. Let's see what he does with the dough. And we have a major decision, 12-0.
It's a win by major decision.
So we are now looking at 36-22. Yeah. All right.
113 pounds for Delaware, Josh Bell, and for the Panthers, Zach Luthawatsa.
Zach Luthawatsa. I was waiting to say that. He is from Hilliard Darby, and his opponent is Josh Bell. Josh is a 10th grader, And I believe Zach is a ninth grader. Okay. Got the takedown. Okay, we have a takedown for Josh. Josh is currently 10-5, and of those 10 wins, he has eight pins. That would pretty much decide it for Delaware if he can get it. Okay, if he can get the fall here, I think that would just pretty much clinch the match for Delaware. We're into the 12th match. He's got a cradle. Let's see what he's going to do here. Get that knee in the side. That's pretty tight right there. Okay, he didn't get it. He got three on the near fall. We're at 5-0. Okay, we have potentially dangerous there. We're going to go back and... About 30 seconds left. We have a 5-0 score in favor of Josh Bell. Okay, we got caution on red. He's got to be on the elbow and on the navel. Better start. Coming back a cradle there, but he didn't get it. Now he works the crossface cradle here. Got 15 seconds. Let's see if he can score. Time. Okay, we're in the second period. It's going to be Red's choice. Red will defer, and Zach will go neutral. So we are at 5-0 at this point. Nice single leg attack, but he didn't drive through. Can he come out the back? Not yet. Well countered there. He's got the cradle. There's a two. So we're at seven. Got an arm bar. Let's see if he can drive across. Got to keep it legal. Certainly clinch it for the for Delaware Hayes. With two matches left, we have a 42-22 score. So at 120 pounds.
At 120 pounds for Delaware, Ryan Chupko. And for your Panthers, Austin Craycraft.
Okay, Austin Craycraft is the 120-pounder from Darby. Delaware Hayes is, I have to get the name for Delaware. What's his name?
This is Ryan Chupko.
Ryan Chupko? Okay, thank you. For Delaware, we have Ryan Chupko. I'll have to check the spelling on that. Okay. Nice takedown for Mr. Craycraft. Ryan is a ninth grader, and it's spelled C-H-U-P-K-O. So with the match well in hand, Coach Heffernan decided to substitute there. So we got the takedown. I see a still a 2-0 score.
Escape one, Chupko.
Okay, we have an escape. We're at 2-1. In favor of Austin Craycraft from Hilliard Darby. We got a 42-22 team score with just one match left. Yeah, just a reminder, the best way to see this production will be on probably YouTube, MATSIDE TV. If you do have Spectrum, it's on channel 25. We broadcast Monday through Friday. So hopefully you'll look for that in the near future. Time's out. We are 4-1 going in second period. Green defers to red. So Austin deferred to Ryan Chupko. Okay, he's going to give him one. So we're at 4-2. Nice double leg off the whistle, scored there. Had a chance to get the half, didn't get it, but still a nice takedown. There's an arm bar, opposite side half. Then he went to the wrist. I believe Austin's a 10th grader. Let me double check that. Yes, he is. Now we got stalling on top. Okay, gonna let him go again. So we are now at 6-3. As I mentioned, this is the second to last match. We started this this evening's duel at 1:32, and we've worked our way through 12 matches, of which 9 have been by pen. And again, that's you know, that's the name of the game. When we can put him on his back, your opponent, you can score the big points here. So Delaware's definitely had the advantage with the falls. It's a nice attack, didn't score. So we're still at 6-3. We have 15 seconds left. And we're working.
Circle! 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 Circle!
Okay, final period. Austin will go down. He had it, just didn't do it. Yep, he got the one. Nice escape there on the edge. I was looking at the stones on the mat and I got lost on where I was. So we're at 7-3. About a minute and a half, there's a nice lateral to his back. He's got the takedown, but didn't score the points. You got to control. He definitely had the takedown, but didn't get the two backs. So we're looking at 9-3. I hear the mats being rolled up on my left side. We got Stalling on top, and it's going to be one. That's the second stall call, so he gave up one. Okay, he's going to go neutral. Not a bad choice. He was warned and penalized for stalling, so Austin decided to go on his feet. I'd say that's a good move. You're up 9-4. Let's see if he can score in here. The match has basically been decided, but we're still wrestling. Okay, let's sit back. Nothing yet. And there's the. Okay, game the two. So we're at 11-5, which is a regular decision. 15-5. If he turns him, he can get a major here. Let's see if he can do it. We got 5 seconds left. It looks like it's going to end up 11-5.
It's a win by decision at 120 pounds for Austin Claycraft.
Okay, Austin Claycraft from Hilliard Darby, winner by decision, 11-5. Our final match tonight.
At 126 pounds for Delaware Hayes.
And Zach, as I mentioned earlier, is a 10th grader, so had a lot of young guys wrestling tonight. It's good for the future. There's two. Isaac scores with about 35 seconds left, but he will be penalized for locking hands. So we got a technical violation. Red will score on the locking hands. That's been our first penalty tonight. So it's been a clean match. A lot of falls. We've had 9 falls out of the 13 matches that have been wrestled. When I give a brief ending here, I can talk a little bit about it. Yeah.
Time is out, so we are at 2-1. First quarter, Delaware will choose, well, that'll defer, actually. And Green will choose down, so Isaac chooses down. We got a 2-1 score. There's a nice escape. Had good hand control.
Isaac Richards.
So we were at 3-1.
Look for the pop double. Let's go, Rick. Come on.
I'm getting some help from my folks behind me.
Hey, there it is.
Nice tight head toss. Let's see if he can score here. He's got to settle, get his right arm a little deeper. Get the right arm deeper. Now he gave up on the half, but he got his two. So we're at 5-1.
Come on, Isaac, you gotta keep working.
Forward!
Okay, he's gonna give him an uncontested escape here, which he does.
Escape one,
so we're 8-2.
Come on! Keep working! Keep working!
Little over 40 seconds left in the period, second period. Darby's forward on that little slide by. And he got the two and gave him one. So we are at 10-3.
Come on, Isaac.
Okay. Okay, we're in the third period with a 10-3 score in favor of Isaac Richards from Darby. Okay. I'm going to caution Red.
Let's go, Isaac.
Arm was slipping off the elbow.
Keep going. Back up again.
Come on, Isaac. Come on, Isaac. Head up.
Okay. Looking for a cross face cradle.
Control the hand. Isaac, control the hand.
Get rid of the hand.
Went to the other side.
Up.
He got to his feet. Cradle, but he's going to run out of space here. Okay. They're out of bounds. Got a little over a minute to go.
1:12 left in the match.
Hey, he stops your stand up. Go right into a changeover.
Let's go, Isaac.
You put multiple moves together. Stand up to a changeover. Head up, head up.
Stand up, Mom.
There you go.
Got about a minute left. We got a in the final match of our dual meet tonight at Hilliard Darby. Got a 10-3 score. If he can slide out the back door. Nice job. We're at 12-3. We got a major.
Isaac Richards.
About 20 seconds left. Got a major decision at this point. See if he's going to get two here. Time. Nope. It ended up 12-3 in favor of Isaac Richards.
Major decision for Darby's Isaac 40, Richards.
42-30. Okay. Okay. Ready to roll here? Okay, we just finished up our dual meet between Hilliard Darby and Delaware Hayes. Interesting how this all worked out. They both won 7 matches. So of the 14 matches wrestled, they both won 7. But here's the catch. Delaware won all 7 by falls. So that takes the score to 42-30. Nice win for Delaware Hayes. Good crowd tonight, and I think it was a decent duel, but as I mentioned, the 7 wins for Delaware came by all falls, and that will give them their final 42, where Darby won a couple by decision, they had a couple major decisions, and they scored 30. So from Hilliard Darby High School, this is Rick Baker for MATSIDE TV, and I'm signing off.
Future leaders we can believe in? Look no further than the high school student athletes right here in Ohio. High school sports teach young people how to be effective leaders. It includes learning to listen, accepting responsibility, being a good role model, and it's about respect. The result, it transcends sports. It gives us hope for the future. This message presented by the Ohio High School Athletic Association and the Ohio Interscholastic Athletic Administrators Association.